Welcome. This is lecture 3. We're learning 3D Studio Max and you're watching 5minuteMax. So all you have to do is give 5 minutes from your time and learn the program, learn the philosophy of the program. In the previous lesson or day 2, we talked about the select object button and what it does. So let's create something new again, because we are going to like constantly create stuff. That's like what we are like trying to achieve here. Always try to model, practice stuff, and constantly get better. Alright. You'll be watching me doing all this every once in a while, but fear not, you will be learning all this. Okay, I just made a 3D arrow, just like the previous one. Now, let's try, you know, to understand what this is. The previous one was select object, and we will be dealing with something else in this one. We'll be dealing with the very stuff that I'm moving right now, which is called select and move. Alright, so select and move is the second one. It will be like really important to do, manipulate your object, or to move certain stuff in your viewport. So this is the viewport where you can see all the stuff. Now this is like the cursor that you have to always remember. This is that select and move. You select that and you can like get these three arrowheads in a 3D space. One is red, green, and blue. So R, G, and B, X, Y, and Z. So do this exercise every once in a while until you get how the 3D space works within 3D Studio Max, and you're constantly going to like improve yourself. You can take that as word. So select and move, every object has select and move option, so you can basically move any object using this. But just for the practice, what we have learned in lecture 2 is if you press Q or select object, look, it's disappeared. Now you cannot do anything with this one. But if you press on this one, select move, it comes back those three arrowheads. And when you're doing this, you can like move them, but not when you're on in select object mode. So keep practicing that. You will be seeing this, I mean select and move, in many places in 3D Studio Max. And you're also going to find rotate and scale as well, but hey, that's going to happen tomorrow. We're just going to learn furthermore through the toolbar to understand and comprehend the basic functions that you will be working with most of the time inside Max. So select and move, the shortcut key is W. It's right beside Q. So Q is just for select object, and select and move is W. See you guys on lecture 4. And until then, have a good one.